Check this out.
He's got everything that I used to be like.
Since the return of her stay on the moon, she listens like spring and she talks like June.
73. Yes, it is 73.
But tell me, did you sail across the sun?
Double A for
11-3. Did you make it to the Milky Way?
It is 11-3. He beats his
arms.
I'm okay, I'm relaxed and I'm enjoying it, and that's the difference.
One without a permanent scar, and then you miss me while you were looking for yourself.
Oh, and the punishment continues.
No treble. Another treble or single. Bullseye!
And then she's back from that soul.
In the middle. The time against a 10.
Double four.
16 for match play. 16. And he's done it!
Tell me, did you sail across the sun? Did you make it to the Milky Way to see the lights of fading?
History
makes it 16. Tell me, did you find a shooting star? One without a permanent sky. You miss me while you were looking for yourself.
Carrera, the range that defined target since 2013, has been reimagined. Carrera Azuri, a range currently only available in Japanese-style softtip. Modified and enhanced pixel grip darts, coated in an Azuri blue titanium nitride for a stunning and protected finish. Now available in three new steel tip designs. two new soft tip designs, and revitalised new packaging. Carrera Azzurri leans on the original concept of Carrera, and then taking it to a new level. The new Carrera Sport Range. More dynamically designed barrel shapes, coated and coloured in a polychromatic titanium nitride coating for a sportier new look. The Carrera Sport Range in three steel tip barrel shapes, Charger, Nitro and Turbo. As well as three soft tip versions. The new Carrera Sport Range. Two new barrel weights for the best-selling Carrera C4s, the original Pixel Grip. A new, colourful range of Carrera flights. New to the target range, Agora is the introduction to precision mill dart grips. Agora features a combination of radial grips and precision milling to create a premium yet introductory dart design. Multiple mill cuts on each barrel provide a solution for multiple grip starts. Agora is available in four steel tip barrel designs, each in two weights. And three specially designed soft tip barrel weights. A wide range covering the key barrel shapes and providing an introduction to target's precision milled darts. Accessorize your new Agora darts with these stunning new Agora Plus flight designs. Ghost Plus is an enhancement of our original Ghost design, with the colour printed over silver for a more vibrant, enhanced colour. In 2016, we reinvented and redefined our 80% tungsten darts range with Vapor 8. In 2017, we take this to a higher level with the Vapor 8 Black. An 80% tungsten barrel with detailed axial cuts, overlaid with the performance quality black titanium nitride coating, delivering enhanced grip and barrel protection. Highlighted with vivid coloured ring sections, red, blue and green highlights give this range a distinct recognition. And like the original Vapor 8 range, the wide variety of barrel shapes, grip position ensures there is a barrel to suit all. The Vapor 8 Black range delivers. Introducing Colours 2. An entry-level 70% tungsten soft-tip darts range, featuring radial grooves and metallic painted rings. This colourful, playful darts range is the perfect solution for aspiring soft-tip players. Sport 90, the flagship range for the Diamond Pro Point. A new addition to the range with the Aspire barrel shape, available in 24 and 26 grams. Tacoma Wallet. The new Tacoma XL. Based on our best-selling Tacoma Wallet, the new, larger version holds two fully assembled sets of darts and provides extra accessory storage. Tacoma Wallet, now available in two new vivid colours to join our best-selling ranges of hard case dart wallets. Target has led the way in enhanced dart point technology, and we now bring you the Nano Storm Point. Available in silver, gold and black, both in 26 and 30mm. Nano provides a new grip on the point and reduces bounce outs, with the storm element reducing deflections. Quartz and Onyx join the Diamond Pro Point in providing new and unique point grips. These coated and hardened points are laser engraved for added board and finger grip. New Sierra Flights available in number 6, number 2, kite and vapor shapes.
Ladies and gentlemen, here is a video we put together about a living legend. Phil, we made this video for you, mate. You're a living legend. I hope you enjoy it.
You have to understand, in the world of sport, every now and again a player comes along and dominates and takes the sport to another level. But there's never been, in the history of sport, globally, a sportsman that has dominated for such a period of time. To win 16 World Championships, over 100 other ranking events during a career spanning 30 years, is something that we've never seen anywhere. There is no other sportsman in this world that can be compared to Phil Taylor.
Look, there's so many elements that have made the sport great what it is. Phil is one of them. Without him, would it be so popular? Of course not, because every sport needs a standard bearer, and he's been that since 1993 or four, really, along with Dennis Priestley. They were the first ones that elevated the standard. Phil kept it going for the next two decades.
There are very few sports where one man defines the sport, is almost responsible solely for the growth of that sport and making it what it is today. We talk about Tiger Woods in golf, but in darts we talk about Phil Taylor. He took darts, really, with the help of a lot of people at the PDC and Barry Hearn, and made it what it is today, a household sport and one of the greatest success stories in the sporting world in the 21st century.
He's done 16 world titles. Just think about what he's done globally, around the world. I think somebody added it up to be over 200 titles. I looked once and thought it was nearer 400. I mean, no one really knows what he's done. We just know it's a lot. And will there ever be another Phil Taylor? I don't think there will. I don't think anybody has the legs that he's had, the determination that he's had.
He's our greatest sportsman, let alone just the greatest dart player there's ever been. He's the greatest sportsman. He's had the, he's got the biggest accolades that you could have.
He is the name that everybody has tried to emulate, and he is the name that, even if people don't really know about darts or don't follow darts, they know who Phil Taylor is.
Phil's made the game as what it is today. That's off to him for that.
He's a legend, isn't he? How he comes back from getting beaten and people writing him off, and he comes back even stronger and destroys everybody. That talent, the way he's got, I don't know what it is, but it's amazing.
Everyone wants to see Phil Taylor. He's the best dart player that has ever graced the planet.
Phil's made this game, and he's made it what it is, and that's why we're playing for the prize money we play for. The interest it's got, the sponsorship that it's got.
Even though how much he's won, he still stayed hungry and still wanted to win everything and be the best. So that's probably a rarity too, to do it over that many years.
Back comes Taylor. Oh yes, he turns round to the crowd. Eight for him, they're loving it. But will this be it? Look at this. This is what this game's all about.
I used to practice with a couple of players, and they used to come in and they didn't turn up for the next session. And in the end, Phil was unemployed, and he said, I'll turn up and play with you every day. And he practiced with me every day. And then in the end, he started improving and whatever else, and I just took him around the world, chasing world ranking points. And he got better and become a dart player. He wasn't a great dart player to start with. I mean, he lost first round in Vegas, first round in Sweden, first round in Denmark. But then as the years went by, he got sick of losing and started to enjoy winning. So he'd done that for 30 years.
For the title, double 10. It's there! It's there! He jumps up, he shakes hands with Bristow. Bristow, the champion in the 80s. Phil Taylor there, the champion in the 90s. We have a new era in the sport of darts.
There's been literally dozens of great games that I've had the pleasure of commentating on involving Phil Taylor, but the one that really sticks out was his last World Championship win in 2013, when he beat Michael van Gerwen, who was obviously the next great upcoming darting superstar. Phil Taylor had struggled to beat Raymond van Barneveld in the match before, and he was suffering with a really heavy cold bordering on flu, and people were writing him off and said he'd never win the World Championship again. And in that game, Michael van Gerwen had him on the ropes, but Phil Taylor just hung on in there and produced some of the best darts of his career to win his 16th world title, and for me, the sweetest of the lot.
Greatest game I ever saw Phil play was against James Wade in the final of the Premier League, when he done 2-9 darters, and narrowly, I think he got 7 trebles to do 3-9 darters in the same match. So yeah, I guess that's probably one of the best performances I've ever seen him play.
The greatest game I've ever seen Phil Taylor play. He's played so many.
I mean, the one against Adrian Lewis in the Grand Slam when they hit like 30-odd 180s in that match and Phil went on and won it. But do you know what? Although I've seen hundreds of Phil Taylor's games, I'm going to go with the one when he beat Michael van Gerwen in Australia last year, because everybody was kind of thinking he's dead and buried, and he weren't. And he stepped up, the old boy, and beat the young contender and put him in his place.
The greatest game of darts I ever see was Lewis Taylor on 2013 match play. Phil wins it with 111 average. Adrian played at 107. How did you not win that at 107? It's unbelievable. But that's Phil Taylor for you. Fantastic. Legend.
Blackpool this year. Blackpool was a thing. He hadn't won a major for 2-3 years. Went to Blackpool. This is his last time at Blackpool. He loves Blackpool. And then he went through the field and he didn't have an easy draw. He started off with a Welsh lad, done him, then he done Barney, then he done Michael van Gerwen, then he done Lewis, and then he beat Peter Wright in the final. And what a way to end his last year.
I think what I miss most about Phil when he retires is, now that we're taking the game truly global, is just seeing the excitement on people's faces when they know that we're bringing him to town.
His averages every single match, his titles, you know, 16 match plays, 16 world titles, you know, how many Grand Prix, how many Premier Leagues. Simply amazing, more than, I believe, 90 televised events. There's no other player who comes near him, you know, and globally he puts darts on the map as well. And we're going to miss him next year.
What we will miss is watching a winner in action. Someone who doesn't like defeat is not abnormal. Someone who detests defeat is surreal. Taylor is a winner.
I'll miss the fact that he won't be in the draw. I'll miss the fact that I'll be mentioning possible winners of events. I can't mention Phil Taylor anymore.
Just the aura of his walk-on. I mean, it's the best walk-on on darts. It's got the atmosphere of a wrestling walk-on where the crowd goes mental. It just gives you chills.
I'll miss Phil Taylor's greatness on the hockey. And a lot of players, if they could learn off him, this bloody mindedness not to never give up, never to doubt your own ability.
I really miss his dominance. He was such good for the game. Always winning. You never remember a tournament without Phil Taylor being in it.
Just his general dedication over the years. It's just a phenomenal achievement.
Phil, the one thing I will miss the most is driving around and taking the mickey out of absolutely everybody and everything that we see.
I'll miss the banter and his rubbish jokes.
Miss about Phil. He comes out with the worst one-liner jokes I've possibly ever heard.
I'll miss the short jokes that he likes to tell. They're not very good. They're not very good. They never were. They never will be, Phil. But you love telling them. We love listening.
What I won't miss about Phil Taylor is his terrible jokes. He is the worst comedian the world's ever seen, and no one has told him until now.
I miss least about Phil. It's got to be his farting in the practice room.
He's farting in the practice room.
What I won't miss about Phil when he retires is when he texts me and says, just two more tickets for tonight, mate.
Yeah, I won't miss him turning my radio up. So when someone comes down the radio, it screeches in my ear.
What won't I miss about Phil? Well, obviously, really, isn't it? He just sort of used to annihilate people, didn't he?
The thing I'd miss least about Phil is he's beat me a few times, so yeah.
I won't miss losing to him.
I won't miss him kicking my backside.
Any good memories of Phil? Not really, because he kept beating me all the time. I mean, I always remember when the draws used to come out. I played him once, and then I was playing him again in 2 days' time, and I felt I was on death row because I was just waiting 48 hours for the execution.
He nearly bought me a drink at the bar once. And then some bloke stepped in and says, Phil, don't be getting that. Me and Lloyd here. I mean, I'll never forget it. Good time, but maybe I'll get one off him one day.
I played Phil in Australia when I first met him, and back home, we've got a custom that you give a guy a kiss on the cheek when you meet him or after a game. And I gave Phil a kiss on the cheek, and he didn't understand what it was. And he turned as I got to kiss him, and it actually went lip on lip. So that was my funniest moment.
Funniest moment with Phil? The guy ruined my career. I can't name any funniest moments with him. I'm glad he quits.
Funniest moment with Phil? Shop visit in Tokyo. Last minute before we was going on the way to the airport. Said to Phil, there won't be many people there, which typical Japanese, there weren't. They'd done what they said when we got there. The owner is a massive Phil Taylor fanatic, and he's
showed me a bit of paper, and the interpreter said, can you get Phil to sign this for me? Phil was sitting down signing a few things. And I've looked at it. What's that? So anyway, I took it over to Phil. I said, Phil, can you sign this? He went, yeah, it's all right, Gaz, I'll sign that. He said, who's that? I said, it's you, mate. And I just couldn't stop laughing. It's the funniest thing ever. Mine's worse.
The funny memory is that I've had a few little nicknames, Milky Bar Kid and whatever, but he said, I've got a shirt made for you. And I said, oh, great. He said, it's a new nickname. He wouldn't tell me what it was. Gave me the shirt, Keith Dynamite Della. I thought, that's not bad. I said, why Dynamite? He said, well, you normally blow out in the first round.
Phil's a funny bloke. I mean, you know, he is what he is. He's a really funny bloke. He said to me once when he walked on, he said to me that he pointed to a bloke in the audience and said he had a big head. And when I looked round, it was one of them big polystyrene heads. So, you know, it was a sort of play on words. But that was very, very funny at the time.
Any advice to Phil now he's retired? Start enjoying himself for a change. Yeah. Chase the sun and spend your money, you tight son.
All right, Phil, sorry I can't be at your party. I'm in China playing some snooker on the hectic schedule, as you know it is these days. But listen, mate, I want to just congratulate you on your retirement. There's no sportsman on the planet, and I'm talking about all sports. I'm including Tiger Woods, Federer, you name them all. There's only one governor, and that was you, Phil. You were the master of the masters. Pleasure to know you, legend, and you can still bash them up, even if you fancy coming back from retirement, mate.
Hi, Phil, Kevin Keegan here. I know this is your last year. You're going to retire. My advice to you is don't do it, mate. You're still the best. But whatever you decide to do, you'll always be number one for me, mate. Enjoy your life, and it's been brilliant watching you over these years.
Phil, happy retirement when it comes. But do you know what? I've been a world number one. You've been the world number one for a long, long time. 16 world titles. I'd love to have had one. The game's going to miss you, buddy. Good luck and God bless.
Phil, I wish you all the best for next year. Yeah, nice exhibitions, no stress, and I wish you a long, happy, healthy life.
What a massive step you're taking, walking away from something you've dominated for most of your career. I can't say I'm going to miss you. with the 2-9 darts you hit against me, I'm certainly not going to miss that. No, I wish you all the best. I hope you find some stuff in life that you're going to enjoy. Take it easy, put your feet up, spend some of that money you've earned.
It's been an honour over the last 10 years to play against you, to watch you, to get beat by you, you know, and we just wish you a very happy retirement. Please stay retired.
You're still the best player in the world, mate, and you're the best ever, so be proud of yourself.
Put your feet up, go and have a nice relax, and just chill out and enjoy yourself.
I'm actually pleased for him that he's now going to retire and actually enjoy his life. You know, he's put so much hard work in and, you know, he deserves it. He deserves to travel the world and do what he wants, you know. I'm quite pleased he's retiring for himself.
Phil was the man. Phil still is the man, and no matter what people say, he always will be the man.
Phil Taylor is the greatest of all time. He's a legend.
Phil Taylor, the power, the greatest of all time.
Phil Taylor is the greatest of all time, and he's a legend.
He's an inspiration and the greatest player of all time.
He inspires us to be better, greater.
He's got courage. He lives and breathes a game.
He won the heart of the people.
Phil Taylor is my hero.
His legacy will live on forever.
There rarely is only one Phil Taylor.
No one will ever fill your shoes.
From the bottom of your heart, thanks, Phil. Top man.
Thank you, Phil.
Thank you, Phil.
Thanks, Phil.
Thank you, Phil.
Thank you, Phil.
Thank you, Phil.
Thank you, Phil.
Thanks, Phil.
Thank you, Phil.
Thank you, Phil.
Phil, mate. Thank you.
Thank you, Phil.
Thank you, Phil.
Thank you, Phil.
Thanks, Phil.
Thank you, Phil.
Thanks, Phil. Thanks, Phil.
Phil, thank you what you did for our sport.
Big thank you to you, Phil. Great, mate.
Thank you, Phil.
Everything what you've done for our sport's been amazing. Thank you.
Phil, thank you very much for the ride. It's been brilliant. I just don't want to get off.
Phil, if I could just say one thing, it's been an absolute honour and a privilege and a pleasure to walk in a Taylor Wonderland. Cheers, pal.
We love you, Phil!
Phil, winning the world match play for the 16th time. Fantastic. Beating the world's best in your side of the draw. What an achievement. Now for the world championships. Go and make it 17.